Hey everybody, welcome back to Fox Plays Zelda Breath of the Wild. We need to get on over to Kakariko Village again. Unfortunately, let's make sure, but I don't think, we don't have a quick travel platform there, so we're going to grab a horse out of the stable here. Okay, yep. There's a horse taming competition. Interesting. All right, done. A tame off. That's a thing. Margaret, it's 2 minutes flat, so you need to bring back a wild horse within 2 minutes. Prepare for extreme taming. All right, let's see. We need a horse. Okay, we got a few candidates right here. I'm gonna go with this brown one since it's the closest. Oh, come on. You guys are the worst. Okay, time to die. Oh, dear lord, this horse is not going for me. Okay, well, at least he's running back toward the staple. Stable, that is, not the staple. Stay where you are. Stop running. Okay, this is not going well. Alright. I'm just gonna go for one of these horses over here. Let's hope that more of those choo-choos don't... It's always funny saying that. Don't pop up and spook him. Oh, you guys, what? I disagree. Okay, this guy, this is the candidate right here. Really don't have much time to try anything else. Oh no, get back on him. Okay, go faster. We didn't have to soothe him or anything. This was the best possible outcome. No, come on. Oh, if I get this lucky and don't make it. Oh, okay. All right. There we go. Nice. 50 rupees. Wasn't difficult, and that'll be useful. Now, let's just take this guy. We haven't actually registered him, but that's okay. We'll take him up to Kakariko. See if he'll follow the big path like this. Yep, cool. I really like this whole pathfinding thing that games are doing with horses nowadays. Come on, calm down. Go the direction I want you to go. Like in Witcher 3, it wasn't the best at all times, but it worked pretty well where the horse you were riding would just follow the path you were following. And you didn't have to do much. You didn't have to do much micromanaging, which was nice. Okay, don't run into a wall then, you dumb. Oh, come on. You like me, you know you like me. Alright, we are almost there. If I remember correctly, we're not far from the gate to Kakariko. We gotta go talk to Impa again. To get more information on, I believe, like, the memories that we need to find. or like recall, I guess would be the term. There's a shrine nearby, which I'm gonna guess is up. We'll get to it eventually. Oh, okay. Not allowed to sprint in the village. But a horse will still take us there. Got a rooster up on, or a cuckoo up on top of the. All right, thanks, horse. You've been a big help. Wait for me out here. Let's go talk to Impa again. Okay, why do we have to come all the way over here just to learn that? Maybe there's one that's close. Alright, so there's a shrine nearby, which I want to do. So follow this path up to the up the mountain. Seems like a direction that we'd go. It's a little like outcropping over there. We go. Hey, look at that. Perfect. The Talo Naig Shrine. After this, we'll be able to get another boost to our. We'll boost our stamina. Alright, so this is shrine number 8 for us. Big open room. So we got a chest. Easiest chest in the world. The Eightfold Blade. Oh, that's so cool. I'm so excited to use that. We'll use our sickle until it breaks, though. Shield of the Mind's Eye. Okay. Oh, dang it. Okay. It's alright. We'll have a shield that we can get rid of. Let's get rid of this one. Thank you. Alright. Alright, we got a sword-wielding robot thing. Side hop to avoid enemy attacks or create an opening that you can use to strike back. Alright, let's equip the sword because I really want to use the Eightfold Blade because that's an awesome name. Even though only 8 folds on a sword wouldn't really give it a whole lot of strength. But that's alright. It's a cool name anyway. Okay. Do a backflip to avoid enemy attacks and create an opening to strike back. Okay. All right, I need to jump at the right time. Okay. Repel attack if you pair with your shield at just the right time. Strike back in the opening you create. All right, this one will be a little more dangerous because we have to open ourselves up. Oh, I see. We parry. Nope, we don't have to open ourselves up. Okay, lift. Oh, I thought I had that one. There it is. Build up your power, then release it to release a charge attack. Catch your enemies in this motion to damage them. There it is. Oh, and we get its blade. Not very durable, but... Okay, we don't have any space for it. Not durable, but it's probably better than something we have. Well, good thing we've done a lot of combat. Now we know how to do that. That will make combat a lot better, I think. Knowing how to actually fight well. Let's get rid of a club. Let's see if we can spot any more chests. No, we already got two chests here. Two pretty awesome chests. Plus we got whatever's in here. An opal. Nice. And now let's get our spirit orb. Thank you. Alright, now we can go down into the village where that shrine is and upgrade our stamina. Alright, so let's jump down. Shrine is right there in that little pond. Want a stamina vessel? Thank you very much, weird rock shrine wearing a bib. Oh, nice. Okay. Though I know the spot where it's likely located, it's really hard to get there. I'm not sure I can do it. Even if it's just a picture, I'm dying to see it. Okay, I can take a picture of it for you. There's a suspicious place I have my eye on. In fact, I was about to head there now. Alright, let's do it. Like how that cuckoo was just sitting there listening to us the whole time. Awesome, we get to go check out a great fairy fountain now. We'll follow Pikango here. Gonna do this so I can just push the thing forward and not ever run ahead of him. Well, I think it was in Red Dead Redemption where you could just, when you were following somebody, you would just set it, like get in line with them, and then you would automatically follow, and that was really nice. That was a good little touch. Especially since you went pretty far distances across the desert in that game. Speaking of which, I'm super pumped for Red Dead Redemption 2. There were some really great moments in the first one. Especially with the music. Should be along the path that leads past the shrine. Okay. I'll get a picture of it, no problem. Alright, so set along the path, which we're on a path right now. Really like that, even though Kakariko Village is right there. It kind of feels like we're in a whole different... Is there another shrine right there? Or no, just like a pile of orange... Okay, we'll check that. That actually might be what we're looking for. Let's go check that out. No, that doesn't look like a great fairy shrine, although I guess I don't know what they look like. But we're going to find out... Ooh, hey look, fairies! Blue nightshade. Alright. Oh, this is the Great Fairy. Few and fewer travelers arrived to offer me rupees. As a result, my power has abandoned me. I'm near the palace now, so I beg your help. I need rupees to become whole again. You know what? I don't trust her. Is that really what she needs? Because that seems ridiculous. I'm going to start collecting some flowers. Silent Princess. This lovely flower is said to have been a favorite of the Princess of Hyrule. Once feared to have gone extinct, it's recently been spotted. Okay, well, I'll have some to give her. Endura Carrot. Nice. Lots of good little plants around the fairy's plant hut thing. Let's see what happens when we talk again. I still don't trust her. I'm gonna go check the path that we were on before and see. Something tells me that the Great Fairy is not gonna require rupees. I feel like there's something else that we should check out. If you know, you know what I mean? It just, I feel like it's a trick of some kind. Get out of here, Ram. Oh, we got a magnesis puzzle up there, it seems. Alright, let's, oh, I see, we want to fill in the circle on the right. Look like snails. We want to go to nope, not stasis, magnesis. Let's take it, fill it in right. Come on. So close. There we go. Thank you. Okay. I don't really want to run that far. We're going to give 100 rupees to this weird thing in the pumpkin. And if we get tricked, if it's a trick, I will just be able to say, I told you so, but also, I'm a fool. So, we're gonna do it. Squirrel. Something up in this tree. Let's climb up and see what is there. Oh, bird eggs. Nice. Okay, let's give this lady 100 rupees. All right. That seems like a pretty great fairy. Ooh, enhancing my clothing. Oh, I see. Okay. How do I not have 5 pecans? Oh, I sold them. That's true. Okay. I need horns. Alright, good to know you're there, though. Even though you required 100 rupees to be powerful. It's very... very capitalistic of you there, great fairy. Oh, I need to take a picture. For that guy. Let's see. Nope, don't want that. I want to take a picture. I don't think I can take a picture with the fairy in it. So let's hope that's enough. Oh, I found it. No big. It was so close. You gave up at the worst time. Oh, big mountain east of this village. It's called Mount Lanayru. Base of Mount Lanayru on the west side of Nadra Snowfield lies that gate. I'm almost certain. Good to know. Thanks, Kango. Way to be super lazy, bro. I don't know if that horse is still here, since it's not actually my horse. I'm guessing it just ran off. What we're going to do is stay for the night. And then make our way to where Pekango just told us to go. Ooh. Yeah, I'm going to use a regular bed since I'm running low. This guy seems too sleepy to be an innkeeper. All right. So we want to. What did Pekango say? Let's look at the adventure log. Pull a picture in there. Traveling to the places shown in these pictures may help you. I think he said east, and so I want to go. Lanayru Heights. I want to go to. There it's Mount Lanayru, Nadra Snowfield. That's where I want to go. So, how do I get there? Looks like we can go up through. Okay, I want to go here for now. So let's. I'm going to go. Oh, hey, look, it's the horse. Convenient. Come on. You got it. You're a blue horse, which is weird, but you seem to be okay. Oh, this doesn't seem the way to go. This little kid's crying. Oh, snap. Of course. Okay, so let's look at our map. We probably don't want to glide that way. Iron sledgehammer. Alright, let's drop something. Probably this guy. Oh, I think we just replaced it. So I thought that was a one-handed version, but it apparently isn't. Okay, so we're gonna go back and continue past the Great Fairy Fountain like we did before. That seemed to be a decent direction to go if we want to get to the snowfield. We're gonna use the... Nope, that's not a... That's just a fire. We want a cooking pot. Which I'm sure there's one in the city. But it's not that important. Come on. Go faster. You got this. I believe in you. You're gonna fall off a freaking cliff not listening to me. Dag, I am out of the city. Let me gallop. Come on. There we go. There we go. Good job. Now you can run faster. Lanayru Road, West Gate. That's a good sign. Alright. Seems as though we want to... Let's go this way. Awesome big open field here. There's a fire. Let's go check out who's by that fire. Okay, I guess... Oh, yep, somebody's here. Let's go talk to them.
Hey!
Eric. Zora's domain. Awesome. It's a town in Lanayru. Crossing the Rutula River is impossible. It's a hard place to get to, so I just gave up altogether. North Tower? You know, with me on the other side of the Rutula River, you can see a huge tower on the opposite bank. Thought I heard a voice coming from the top of that tower. I wonder if someone's up there. Walk patiently to Linebeck Island in the east so you can circumvent it. Nope. Thanks, bro. Oh. I think I just saw the tower that he was referring to. We don't want to go that way, though. We want to go south. Oh! Looks like we got, like, a moose or a deer An elk, I guess, would be the accurate one. He needs to hunt. Get out of here. What an idiot. Alright, let's check our map. No, we want to be going farther south. I guess there's mountains in the way, so we just gotta follow and go where we can. Okay. I think that's the mountain. Mount Lanayru. Let's continue just this way. Okay, don't run into a friggin' tree. Oh, nope, we chose the wrong fork in the path. Oh, this horse is getting real annoying. Oh, I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. The shrine down there. Oh, I know it's nearby. Oh, dang it. We keep taking the wrong path. We are not... You know what? Later, man. I don't need... no freaking horse. I might end up regretting that, but... for now, we don't need that horse. Alright, we're gonna turn that off. Why? Alright. Oh! I did not even notice all those spikes. I guess I thought they were just like rocks sticking out of the ground. What we need to do is glide over them like we did in that one. Or maybe there's an entrance. Yep, there's an entrance. Okay. In the next episode, we are going to take a crack at getting into this shrine, and then we're going to complete the shrine. So come back next time, and we'll go in there. All right, thanks for watching, guys.